Hey there, it's Erica from Ever Educating, and today we're going behind the scenes of Loom Pro and going over the top things to know about it if you're teaching online. I have a whole playlist and a PDF about EdTech tools that you can see below, but other than that, we're going to dive right into this tutorial.
Once you download either the Loom Chrome extension or the app to the computer, which is what I've done, you just want to open it up. So I'm clicking the icon up here. And you have the three options, so screen only, cam only, or screen and cam. So if you do screen and cam, your face will pop up in a circle down here. If you do cam only, you'll see the circle, but it actually, you know, once you finish your recording, it is in the shape of the usual rectangle when you're, you know, you're recording yourself speaking using your webcam. So in this case, I'm keeping it screen only, and then you want to make sure that your microphone is working, and you click start recording. Now, once you do this, you'll see the numbers going down here. Once this finishes, give it a couple more seconds before you start, because I've noticed that I started immediately after the one ends, and it gets cut off at the beginning of the video. So now you can go ahead, you know, click present. I can present, you know, this PowerPoint presentation about fairy tales and mythology. And then once I'm done with recording my lecture, I can go ahead and press the stop button here. There is this icon here that works for drawing on the screen, but I've never used it before because it's not something that I've had to use. So I'll go ahead and stop this recording. And you'll notice that it opened up Loom immediately onto the screen. And so depending on how long the video is, will be how long it takes for it to load. But you can go ahead and go down here and change the name of the lecture. So let's say fairy tale lesson. If you want to, you can go ahead and download it onto your computer, and then let's say you need to edit it after the fact, you can iMovie, where the case may be, you can do that very easily, obviously off Loom, but then you'd have to update it to YouTube or upload it somewhere in order for it to appear in its edited version. You can also do some minor trimming with this tool here. Okay, so that's how you just create a video. Obviously, the first tip here is how to create the video. Next, important things to know, it automatically creates a link that you can just copy and share with your students. So you can add it to your LMS site or an email or whatever the case may be. That's the first thing. And what makes Loom so great is that it automatically creates, not email addresses, it automatically creates URLs for you to share with your students. Now keep in mind, if you sign it up for Loom with your EDU email address, you'll get Loom Pro for free, whether you're a teacher or a student, and that's all time. So I definitely recommend that, because if not, you're limited in how many videos you can create on the regular free account, or paying for it, obviously. Why would you when you can get it for free as a teacher or as a student? So the link here is one important tip. Next important tip, privacy. You can do here where you invite people to see it with specific emails, right? So you can say, invite to the students, you put in the email addresses, and they'll be able to see the video. Or you can add a password, and then whatever the password is, you save that. And now when you share it with your students, you also have to share the password as well. And so that's how you add a bit of privacy to the video if you feel that that's necessary. If you don't, you can go ahead and edit the password and remove it. And now anybody can see it if they had the link. So that's two ways that you can add more privacy to the video if you wish. If not, just send a link to whoever it is who needs to view it. Next tip that's important is this call to action button. Go ahead and click it, and you'll see that it adds a button to the screen, though it actually will move eventually. So you can have a button text. So for example, if this presentation is on fairy tales, and I want them to read, you know, a version of Snow White or whatever the case may be, The Little Mermaid, I can have here, you know, fairy tale links. And then I could have the URL that goes to that. So obviously I don't have that currently, but let's say I just put my website at the moment. Okay, I can change the color of the button if I wish to. So maybe I'll make it red so it's easy to see. Okay, and then obviously text color can be changed too, but I like the white here. You can change how the button looks itself, but again, I like that too. And you click save. And now you'll notice when you play the video, let's watch it again. It appears up here, you click on it, and it takes you to the resource that you've added for your students. So this is a great way to connect one URL to the resource that you've created in the video. So once again, going back there, let's pause the video. All you do is go here to the call to action and put in the link and a name how you'd like. You could also add a custom thumbnail. So rather than seeing this page, the first second of the video, they'll see a specific thumbnail. Maybe you actually have a thumbnail that says Myths, Folktales, and Fairy Tales Lesson in big letters so they can know very easily looking at the video what the video is about. That's up to you to decide if you want to do that. Okay. As you notice down here, students can respond to the video in comments with questions, for example, and reply to it as well. So I can show you that. You just click test, and you post it, and there it is, and they can reply too. Notice that it actually has the exact time that they're replying with a comment. So I'm here paused at 19 seconds, this says 18 seconds, so very close. So you can tell your students, hey, if you have any questions for me, pause the video when something comes up, and then create the comment so I know the exact time in the video that question popped up for you, if you want to get that detailed with it. If not, obviously they can just comment whenever you'd like with questions or comments about the video. Now, as I said, editing is not the best here, but you can click trim and it will take you here, and you can see when you click start trimming, what part do you want to trim? So the part that's red will no longer appear in the video. So let's say you had too long of a pause at the beginning. You can go ahead and say that. You can move it there. You can check, right? And then it will start playing right at the beginning when the red is finished. And so you can see, yes, that's it. Or wait, no, I cut off my first word. Let me move it back a bit. And now test it again. Yes, that's correct. And so once you have that, you say remove. And now, as you see in red, that's no longer going to be there. Now, let's say you made an error at this point. You can again say start trimming, and then you can just do it, okay, the error ends there, double check that that's the case, because it'll start playing right after the red. Yes, that's good. Stop, remove. And you can keep going, right, until you reach the end of all the changes you need to make. You can go ahead and click publish changes. This can take a little while to trim, so you're going to have to give it some patience, even though it has a very quick here removal of those scenes. Again, if you have a longer video, it can take much more time. So you're going to have to definitely have patience with this element if you use it. But eventually it will have the trimmed video for you. And again, you can just share it with your students at that point. I wouldn't depend too much on this trimming feature. But if you need it, it is an option for you. So as you can see there, it's a very short video. So that didn't take too long. What's great about Loom is you could actually listen to the video faster than just regular speed. It's one of the pros over YouTube, in my opinion. So just something to keep in mind as well as far as why to use Loom. If you want to keep your videos organized, if let's say you have different courses that you're teaching, you can go ahead and click Move to Folder, and you can create as many folders as you need and decide where the video goes into. So that's one way of organizing on this website rather than having just all your videos listed on one page. I would say those are the major elements of this website. So hopefully this quicker video, you know, worked well for you. If you want a slower version of this tutorial, I do have a full tutorial that's I think about 20 minutes. And so I'll link that in the description box below.
Now here's a bonus tip for you. Though if you've already found this video helpful, I would really appreciate you clicking the like button below and letting me know. But here I'm on my iPad, right? So I mentioned for iPad users. And you can get the Loom app for an iPad. So on here, this is a free PDF annotator app and notes app called Notes Writer, and I'll link that below. I prefer GoodNotes, but that costs money, so I figured I'd share this example because it's free. And so on here, you can create a blank notebook, basically, and you can use your iPad like a whiteboard. And so I have the full tutorial on how to do this in my longer Loom video, but basically you have it open on here, the white page, and then you go ahead and you go to Loom and you click start recording, the record screen. So you can't record your face, only the screen. But once you do that, you know, you start recording whatever it is on your iPad. Right now I'm using the regular recording tool so I can actually show you Loom in this page. But you click start recording, and then you go ahead and, you know, you write out what you want to on here. You can add images, whatever, you can add text, right? Whatever the case may be. So just to show you there. So you can use it as a whiteboard throughout a lecture you give using your iPad. And then once you're done, you just click the red icon button to end the recording, and it goes into your Loom account. So the iPad seems to be in beta testing for the recording, so I tend to use my laptop more, but it is one way really easily of using a whiteboard if you don't have a touchscreen laptop, because I definitely don't. So this is my bonus tip. Okay, so if you have any questions about this or about anything I said before, please let me know in the comments below. I'd be happy to help you out.